Herkimer Building at the Herkimer County Historical Society. And actually, this building is older than our museum building, built in the 1870s. And this is where our library is here. I mean, this is the building that the public comes to the most. If you want to take a walk with me, and I'll show you around. We have our gift shop area here, and then upstairs we have our offices. Come on up with me. We're in the dead end. I think I stuck that. But these are our offices. Our computer room is in here. Everything is a mess. You can see.
That happens.
You research and do a lot of things. You know, things seem to pile up. But this is where our collection, before it is cataloged, goes. You can see we have a lot of work that needs to be done. Our photograph collection is here. That's all organized.
How far back do your photos go?
I don't know what our oldest one is, but. Probably 1870s, 80s, around there.
Any tin types or archetypes?
We do have tin types. Ooh. Yeah, we do. So actually, it's probably a little bit. This is my office here. You can see we have fundraisers going on, so I spread terribly. So don't mind the mess. It's horrible.
So have you had any sort of activity up here? Or...
Well, like this story I told you when we had a program where we had some ghost hunters come, they entered through the front entrance here, where you came in when you first came here, and right away she said, you know, can I take a picture up the stairs? And she did, and she showed me the pictures later, emailed them to me, and right at the top right here were like three orbs kind of looking down at her. But she said, you know, she kind of got that vibe that there was something here. And so I thought that was interesting. But I've never had anything on where I think something happened. But
so what sort of history would there be to, like, associate anything like that? Is there any deaths? Or there?
You know, we did do the house history, but I don't know if we ever did document anybody dying in the home. It was a home. But back then in the 1800s, early 1900s, you did have people die in their home rather than a hospital. So I'm sure that is a possibility here.
And that was where they would show the bodies in the lounge. And,
yes. Yep. Mm-hmm. Okay. Right. So our last room is right over here, and it's in the dark. I apologize. Our director's office is here. Oh, the light that turns on automatically. But she's a little bit cleaner than me, but she has her bad days too.
I believe the sign goes, brilliance is messy.
There you go! I like that. So this is just a bathroom area and a kitchenette, just very tiny. We actually had to literally gut the entire building when we moved in here and start over.
Old fiber wiring.
Yep. It was actually apartments before we had the building, so it was all cut up into rooms. Oh, be careful on the stairs here. We do have a basement, if you'd like to see it, but that's even...
that's the fun part.
We do still have part of the dirt floor down there, too.
Just don't say the word fun, or else fill it in.
I apologize. Oh, my gosh.
No worries.
Oh, my word.
We have a worse mess. I guarantee it.
Okay. Okay, you can go downstairs. Watch your step on these. Smells like a cellar.
Yep.
We have the dirt floor in here.
Foundation's pretty good.
He's not afraid of anything.
Not really.
That's not going to help you until you switch to SNS mode.
There. Alrighty, you want to go upstairs?
Yep. Move over to Suter.
Lights, just to start with. This is our museum. The building was built by Dr. Walter Suter, and if you want to get a picture of him, he's right there in that photograph. He had it built in 1884, but never lived here. He only had his medical office here, so really nobody lived here.
Mm-hmm.
But he did have his medical office, like I said, so he did do autopsies and things like that, fun stuff in the building when he did have it. And he put it in his will to give it to the Herkimer County Historical Society, so we actually are the second owner.
Mm-hmm. And he was responsible for the autopsies and stuff for Roxolano Druce and testifying for
Chester
DeLette and stuff, right?
Yes. Actually, he was the one, William Druce, who was murdered by his wife, Roxolana. The body parts, bone fragments that were remaining, that were found, were studied by him. And he did testify in that case. And I came across an old article once that long time ago, probably in the 30s or 40s, that the janitor was down in the basement here, and he came across all of these, this bucket that had like bone fragments in it. And I don't know what happened to them, but I'm thinking that possibly might have been William Drews hanging around here.
Like a bucket of bones.
That's right.
Except for her, like, you have her rocking chair, don't you?
Yes, we do. You'll see that upstairs. Okay. Yep. Mm-hmm. We can go up there if you like. So we have, of course, that's one of our famous murders that took place. And Chester DeLette is the most famous murderer that was in Herkimer County. He murdered Grace Brown in 1906 at Big Moose Lake. And he was held at the old jail, which is across the street, and his court case took place in the courtroom, where hopefully you will be able to go. And there we go. I'll let you. I think it's on. Our lights take a while to come on, but this depth that I told you about to be careful about is right there. People come down the stairs, and I don't know, they somehow don't see it, but they skip it, and they end up falling.
Right, it's a weird shape, you know, it's kind of angular.
Yeah. I think I turned it off, actually.
Let me see.
That one.
Oh,
no. Oh,
it's
on.
Okay, we're all right.
Yep.
Okay, we'll head upstairs. The lights will get brighter. The rocking chair that I mentioned that belonged to Roxalana Drews is right here. She used that in her jail cell. And we do have some other items. I don't have them out for you, unfortunately.
No worries.
Yeah.
Now, Susan talked about hearing her voice called from down this hall.
Yeah.
What are some of the other unusual things?
That probably is the most unusual, besides hearing noises that old buildings might make. You know, that's pretty much all I've ever heard. But Sue is more open to things like that, and I'm not, for very good reason. So I think, you know, if people are open to it, they can sense things better than others. So I'm leaving that up to you.
That's what we're here for.